Good morning, and thank you, Neil. I'm really very, very pleased to have the opportunity to follow two great science advisors to this podium. Our panel this morning will discuss the future of energy in the United States and the world. My role is to set the stage for an extraordinary group of speakers. The study of issues relating to energy has been an important and long-standing part of the American Academy's work. The Academy's journal, Daedalus, published an issue 50 years ago that is widely credited with establishing an intellectual framework for the then fledgling field of nuclear studies. In fact, I understand that President Kennedy referred to that issue as the Bible on arms control. Today, the Academy continues that tradition with a multi-pronged initiative on the global nuclear future. This project is generating an integrated set of policy recommendations for balancing the growing global demand for civilian nuclear power with the need to strengthen the regime for safety, security, and nonproliferation. This week, the Academy has published the fall issue of Daedalus. I'll show you a copy of it, which is part one of a two-part volume on the global nuclear future. We hope that it will be as influential and groundbreaking as its predecessor. Today's panel will discuss the even broader topic of the global energy future. As President Obama has stated, the choices we need to make to deal with our energy needs will play a very significant role in determining our future prosperity and the overall quality of life around the globe. We face many difficult challenges in connection with energy. Let me just mention a few. Energy, as I think all of you know, is the foundation for economic and social well-being, and we must somehow satisfy the growing demand for energy in the years ahead around the world. The problem arises from the fact that much of the demand for energy is and will be satisfied by fossil fuels. For example, 85% of the energy produced in the United States is derived from fossil fuels. The harsh reality is that the use of fossil fuels, at least in the manner we use them today, is not sustainable. John Holdren made this point this morning. The growing concentration of the resulting greenhouse gases threaten the planet. We face the need to transition to an entirely new energy infrastructure. Energy issues are also tightly connected to national and economic security. This is most obvious in the case of petroleum. We have near total reliance on petroleum to meet transportation needs around the world, but much of the world's supply comes from politically unstable areas through vulnerable supply chains. Energy policy is connected not only to environmental concerns, but to a cluster of difficult security challenges. The problem is made even more complicated by the fact that our energy infrastructure is large and permeates every aspect of our lives. It will be a difficult and hugely expensive undertaking to transform that system. Significant change will take time, require vast amounts of money, and demand sustained effort in a period in which there are many other challenges to confront. And the change must occur across the entire globe if we were to make headway on the climate problem. In short, our energy problem is both hugely important and nearly impossibly difficult. In today's panel, we will hear from four distinguished fellows of the Academy, each with special expertise and a unique vantage point to help us understand our energy future. I hope they will help us to define a path to resolve the complicated set of issues that surround energy. I'd like to invite our panelists to come forward to the table. In your programs, you will find detailed biographies of our four speakers. Each of them will make introductory comments, after which I hope we can engage in some conversation among the panel and then with you, our audience. The first speaker will be the Honorable Stephen Koonin, Undersecretary for Science in the U.S. Department of Energy. Steve is a theoretical physicist. He was the provost at Caltech and more recently was the chief scientist for BP. At DOE, Steve oversees the single largest source of support for basic research in the physical sciences in the United States. He has been a member of the Academy since 1991. Our second speaker is John Rowe, the chairman and chief executive officer of the Chicago-based Exelon Corporation. Exelon is the nation's largest electric utility and also the largest operator of nuclear power plants in the United States. He serves on the advisory committee of the Academy's Global Nuclear Future Initiative and was inducted yesterday. John, congratulations. Paul Josko, president of the Alfred P. Sloan Foundation, will speak next. Paul has been a fellow of the Academy since 1991. He is on leave as the Elizabeth and James Killian Professor of Economics and Management at MIT, where he has served on the faculty since 1972, including 8 years as the director of the MIT Center for Energy and Environmental Policy Research. Today, he leads one of the nation's preeminent foundations supporting science policy, education, and workplace issues. Our final panelist is John Doerr. John is a partner in the Silicon Valley venture capital firm Kleiner Perkins Caulfield and Byers. John has provided support for the creation and growth of numerous companies, first in information technology and more recently in green technology. He is an expert on carbon trading and has brought that expertise to his role as a member of President Obama's Economic Recovery Advisory Board. John was inducted yesterday, and we welcome him to the Academy as well.